Prime Minister Alan Chesney says when he assumed office in 2016, his government organized the first ever policemen and firemen's ball. While acknowledging that the police officers do have their shortcomings, he says the fact that they put their lives on the line to serve and protect citizens on a daily basis make them the nation's heroes, and they should be treated as such.
First of all, these people, these officers, are our heroes. And we spend too much time as a society degrading them and not appreciating what they're doing.
The Prime Minister cited a scenario where a police officer is employed with the force for over 20 years without any life and health insurance benefits. Additionally, he faces heavy criticism from the public. However, the question remains, how does the Prime Minister feel about the performance of the police force? Prime Minister Chesney says he's relatively satisfied, but he acknowledges that there are measures that need to be taken to maximize the full potential of the Royal St. Lucia Police Force, like providing equipment and the revamping of the court system, as well as inspiring confidence in the DPP's ability to prosecute.
So how do you think they feel that arrest somebody, get the evidence, it takes forever because we didn't have a forensic lab? So here's how it goes. We want to be able to send all this evidence to a particular place in the States. So they say, no problem, you can send it, but you didn't pay your last bill. So what you have to do is you have to make sure that you send the money up front. So they go through the Ministry of Finance. The Ministry of Finance says, well, that's not in the budget and you've already spent the money.
Prime Minister Alan Chesney says there are too many obstacles in the system that are frustrating the lawmen, like the unresolved alleged unlawful police killings in 2011. However, he says his government is determined to resolve the issues affecting the Royal St. Lucia Police Force. For the DBS News World, I'm Don Nicholas.